Welcome back to Let's Play Disco Elysium Blind. I'm Amethyst Lunatari. We finally got the rave kids in here. We can talk to a cell. One of the things we're supposed to do. We've got to talk to Soona after this. Get a cell to talk about your associates. Yeah, after you've helped them set up the nightclub. So if it's set up enough, help Egghead with his beat. Walk back to the canal and see if you can find any tapes that could work as a melody. I don't know where we'd find that canal. Yeah, let's talk to Asel. She's whistling a melody, her trusty contact mic attached to a wooden pulpit. At the sound of your footsteps, she stops what she was doing and turns to you.
Hey there. I've been recording some new audio from all these beams and rafters. The sounds traveling through the wood are pretty cool. Creaks and stuff. Like you're underwater, you know? But like, underwater inside a tree.
It's too bad her voice is so soft over the music. She gives you a shy smile. And no, it's got nothing to do with contact Mike. I wasn't going to... She cuts you off before you can finish the sentence. No, no, I actually want to thank you for getting me and my friends in here. And we even found some new associates, such as they are. How's everyone doing? Good, I think. Noid is getting a read on the place. I think he finds the carpentry very impressive. Andre's been setting up the compressor and... dancing. Egghead's keeping the party up. He's got the stage under control. Soona, the programmer, she's doing whatever she does behind that radio computer of hers. She doesn't talk to us much. And the crabman hasn't shown himself, thank God. This is locked into her empathy. Now the tape recorder lies on the wooden floorboards like a discarded toy. Now can you tell me about your associates? Sure, you helped us out. I can repay the favor. What do you want to know? Okay, first... the guy she knows the most. Tell me about Andre. Andre, he's a cool guy. Doesn't really come off as one, but he is. To me, at least. He takes care of stuff. Sorry, I mean he's got a vision of what life should be, you know. He tries to push things until everything falls into place. He's an organizer. Was he organized? Nothing. But then again, there's nothing to organize around here either. He really wants this church thing to work. Must have taken it as a sign when he found it abandoned like that. Said it was an augury. I don't know where he got that from. She smiles. Andre's not super intelligent. I've never seen him so psyched about anything, though. And he's often psyched. Looks sort of desperate. Like it's his last chance or something. Or maybe he was just high. I mean, not that he does drugs. Just high, you know? Corrupt, rotten to the marrow. Oh, okay, on life? Yes. Anyway. Is Andre your boyfriend? Yes, she nods. Yeah, he wouldn't let her in a tent. Some boyfriend. I would have kicked out Noid or Egghead for a while and let her come in. Tell me about the others. What do you want to know about? Tell me about Noid. He's a Farburger, I guess, like the rest of us. Okay, maybe not Egg. I don't know about him, but Noid and the rest are from Farburg. Faulberg? Forberg? Making the pilgrimage up north to visit the Palaceum. He's real hardcore about the lifestyle. What does he do? What do you mean, do? Like, for a living? Yes. He's a carpenter. Trained and all. He's very good. He just doesn't have the mindset to work like that. In a shop somewhere. That's because Noid is violently hardcore. I have internalized it. I understand why he doesn't stoop to servitude. Do you? Actually, I haven't cooked that thought up yet. Wow, you really have talked to him, she smiles. Indeed, Noid serves no master but the beat. And you? Sir, she gives you a switchblade smile, I abide by the law. Inland Empire says, a strange feeling, like before, when you caught her lying better than she should have. Every now and then, something feels off about the way she speaks. She doesn't exactly change tone, but you feel as though there's more about her than she lets on. Maybe Ruby dyed her hair blonde. What is this pilgrimage you're talking about? It's just something poor Farburg kids do every spring to pass the time. We walk the entire length of Boogie Street up the Jamrock, or as much as that's possible. Why wouldn't it be? I don't know, man. Have you been down Boogie Street? It's a little bewildering. Oh, I'm sorry. Have I not told you I'm a raging alcoholic who recently drank himself into oblivion so deep he can't even remember what sounds like the biggest street in the city? No? Well, I am. Okay, then you should go and take a look, I guess. Boogie Street is cool. It's got a lot of immigrants and all kinds of different people. I might just do that if I make it there alive. Yeah, she says, then opens her mouth like she's about to add something but doesn't. What's the deal with Egghead? What do you mean? What does he think he's doing when he yells all that stuff? Oh, that. He's the party boy. He told me as much, but what exactly is a party boy? Analytic music doesn't really do vocals in the traditional sense. Vocals are thought of as rock. That's to say we're a bit backward. No offense if you like rock music, though. Rock music is cool by me. Conceptualization says, Patoo, patoo, swish! Your credentials as the resident future man of Revachol are being questioned. Sure you're a hip with the times, Gramps. You don't have to tell me rock is backward. I am the future man. I abandoned rock in the 30s. Stupid rock. Patooey. Okay, she nods. Anyway, even if you don't have vocals, you still need someone to say something every now and then, right? To urge things on. That's where the party boy comes in. He basically just stands on the stage and dances and yells how awesome everything is. It's very catchy. Kim says, I understand. People are usually afraid to do things if others aren't already doing them. Dancing makes you dance like sneezing makes you sneeze, or yawning makes you... He looks around, a little embarrassed of the enthusiasm of his interjection. Anyway. Where is he from? How long has he been with you guys? Actually, we don't know where he's from. Or who he is, really. One time we were out partying, somewhere in the backwater Farberg, or maybe even Coal City. I can't remember. Maybe it was Coal City. Encyclopedia says, the worst of the banlieues, a wretched heap of closed-down mines even west of Jamrock, on the dusty slope of Monty Martin, the remotest possible area of Revachol. No one even wants to exploit those people anymore. Egg was yelling along to some jams someone was spinning all night long, just kept yelling until he didn't have a shred of voice left. When the sun came up over the mines, there were mines? Yeah, it was in Coal City, she nods. Egg came with us. He made this wheezing puppy dog sound all the way back. Couldn't even speak. It was definitely Coal City because it took us 2 days to walk back to the Fow. He just wheezed the whole way. We never really asked him why he came with us or who he was. I think his name is Jermaine. People are sweet, she says quietly. Empathy says, you can see it must have been a great night. The memory causes her to go silent for a moment or two. Inland Empire says, you wish you'd been there. Actually, do tell me about yourself. Me? Again? Yeah, I forgot. Tell me about yourself. I told you. I'm a silver bird. Reaction speed says there's that phrase again. It really reminds you of something. What does that mean? It means I don't answer questions about myself. There's more to you than you let on. What am I not seeing? All right. She picks up the tape recorder and looks you in the eye. There is. But I'm a police officer. You have to answer me. Is there a law that would stop me from lying, though? That would depend on the circumstances. The lieutenant taps his foot. All right, fair enough. Thank you. Tell me about Soona. She's a bit odd, I have to say. Doesn't talk much. I'm not really sure how to vibe with her, you know? Seems like she's not in a very good mood most of the time. And earlier today, she told me about... Welkins? Cell grimaces, as if it was the first time hearing the word. And she seemed oddly happy, like she had some idea with those little creatures. Some artistic idea. I didn't really listen. I was busy with my mic. What about Tiago? Oh, the crab man, she shudders. Still gives me the creeps the way he moves. but he doesn't actually come down that much, just climbs around the rafters. I just try to stay away from the crab man, but he talks to Noid. They seem to have some thing going on. Oh, he talks to Noid? What for? Beats me. Noid said they get along, somehow. They're both crazy enough, I guess. What does he do up there? Who knows? She shrugs. He doesn't really answer our questions, see? Not that it's easy to ask them. What are we supposed to do? Yell up at the tower? Catch the silver bird. Reaction speed. Probably fail, but okay. I don't know what this even means, catch the silver bird. Failure, of course. The silver bird has already flown away. I will catch it later. Locked until you put in reaction speed. Alright. I had something here. Because we finished this. Everyone letting it all hang out. Elite entertainment zone. I wonder if I can find this guy up here. And then we'll talk to Soona. I hear the nothing, sort of. Yeah, I don't see him around. Alright, let's go. Help Soona.
Yes, what is it?
How's the project going? I see that your neighbors have moved in, but all I hear is Anedic dance music. What? She leans closer, eyes knitted together in a puzzled expression. What did you say? You can barely hear her over the thumping bass of Anedic dance music. I said, how's the project going? I can't hear you, she shouts, pointing at the enormous speaker that's churning out the sound. The music is too loud. The project, how is it going? Oh, the project! Her face lights up for a second before she gives you an exaggerated head shake. It's not going well. Why? There's that guy. She points at Egghead, who's raving behind his turntables on a brightly lit stage. I need him to plug a 3.5 cable into the auxiliary input so that I can route the audio signal through the mixer into the speakers. Why don't you just ask him? He doesn't listen to me. He only ever seems to care about hardcore and Yokokata, a place to be, apparently. I'll speak to him, see what I can do. Thanks. Maybe you can get through the magic rhymes. She does jazz hands to mock him. Let me know how it goes. Talk to Egghead about the aux cable. You have 3.5 millimeter cables, I think it was it.
That's a deal! Yeah! Medium car!
Egg, can you please route Soona's signal through your speakers? To the Mega! Yeah! He gets serious. I can route it through auxiliary. What kind of cable does she use? 3.5 or 4.5? It's 3.5, no doubt about it. It's on the ground. Oh, she's a 3.5. An uncomfortable pause follows. Yeah, the auxiliary line in is 4.5 millimeter. These two don't mix. Oh no. The lieutenant closes his eyes. We're gonna be in this church forever. Don't worry, I have an adapter for it right here. He searches for the cable on the ground and picks it up, looking at the jack. Hang on, this is a 4.5. We're all good, people. With a grin, he sticks the plug into the auxiliary line in. You hear a satisfying click. Whew, thank God. Interfacing says, adapters noticeably degrade the sound quality. Soona says, great, someone got through to him. Okay, let's get it all set up. Can we turn the music off, please? Okay, this is done. Breakthrough imminent, not done yet, right? Okay, egg the music. Everybody, don't panic. I'm going to turn off the Arno for just a sec. The young man shouts as he clicks a switch on the mixer for a special scheduled event. The Arno will be back, but we're doing something else for one moment. He turns to you. All right, go tell her that Egghead is ready to rave to her tunes, and then I'll turn off the music. Okay, this is done. Actual art degree. Trite, contrived, mediocre, milquetoast, amateurist, infantile, cliché, and gonorrhea-ridden, pan to conformism, I screwed me, affront to humanity, war crimes should literally be tried for war crimes, resolutely crap, lacking in imagination, uninformed reimagining of limp-wristed, premature, ill-informed attempt at talentless crap-fest, recidivistic crap peddler, pedantic, listless, savagely boring, just one repulsive laugh after another. Minus one hand-eye coordination from handshake, from anger at how crap it all is. Conceptualization passives heal plus one morale and give you plus 10 XP. I don't like the negative to hand-eye coordination. Conceptualization doesn't come along that often, so accept and forget. Let's go for hardcore aesthetic. And here we've got done. Okay.
Yes, what is it?
All right, I talked to Egghead. He plugged in the cable. You can now unmute your speakers. Okay, but she seems hesitant, her eyes still fixed on Egghead. Think you could ask him to turn the volume down a bit, just in case? Maximum! Shouts Egghead, a great smile still adorning his face, larger than a red dwarf star. Maximum is the only way! I know it is, but could you please turn it down, just this instance? Not just this on time. Maximum is not the only way, okay? Pump it to the brick. Pump it to the hard master. There is no other way. Glue style. See, she turns to face you, ready to give up. He pumps it to the hard master. It's hopeless. Why do you want to turn down the volume? That's a stupid question. Because I'm afraid that something might happen. It's an unknown phenomenon, she turns to Egghead. You can always turn it back up if there's a need. See, I chose that because I'm not sure if the button is stuck. He just doesn't want to turn it down? I'm not sure. Can't turn down the hardcore! Alright, I think what Egghead is trying to say here is that the volume button is stuck on maximum. Well, unplug it for a moment. Of course it is, she shrugs, consigned to her fate. Yeah! Permanent enlightenment! Ray of sound! Never mind then. Let's get on with our project. I'm gonna unmute the speakers on a count of five. Everyone ready? She looks around in the church. Egghead pumps his hand up in the air, waiting for the beat to stop. Or drop, rather. Born ready, says Andre. Ready, yells Noid. Finally, Asel turns to face you and Kim. I'm ready if you two are, detectives. The lieutenant nods stoically. Inland Empire says, suddenly your palms are sweaty. The church seems cold and large somehow. Hold on for a moment. What? Maybe we shouldn't do this. It's too dangerous. On maximum volume 2? No, we should definitely do this. I am going to do this. She pauses, looking around in the church. Everyone stares at her hand on the keyboard. Ready? Okay, no choice. Never mind, let's do this. I'm ready. Whoop! 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Mute disengaged. She lifts her hand from the keyboard. Complete silence fills the room. Perception hearing says, no wind outside, no waves. No floorboards creaking. Total continuous silence. This is unnatural. So did the spot in the middle of the church overtake the entire church? The woman looks around. In the silence you see dust move on the floorboards. The driver of the speaker vibrates in the air and then stops. plasterwork begins to crumble down the walls. In the silence, a low hum starts creeping up your spine. It's a song inside you, not in the speakers, not in the room, a great bass sigh in the basement of your mind. Slowly it builds until the air around you starts to vibrate. Oh boy. Physical instrument says, it's out there now, in the world, made manifest. Half-Light says, it will devour everything. What? The silence will? Inland Empire says, the floorboards, the glass, the streets and the people, nothing will remain. Guys, what's going on? There's alarm in Andre's voice, and as he steps back to scan the surroundings. A slight rattle like crystal clattering in the cupboard fills the air, joining the chorus. It's getting louder, says Noid, his eyes riveted on a strange circle of water basins. Hosiana! Mother of Mega! You hear Egghead yell, then something else, but his voice is growing faint. Empathy says, in his mind, a tidal wave approaching from afar, swallowing entire coastlines on its way. Salvation. It was in me? I don't know. What's that weird rattling sound? The beauty and the beat! The future of dance! Planetary! Intergalactic? No, Egg, it's the window! Asel says. The glass shards around Dolores Day's vacant heart appear to be vibrating from the sound. It almost looks as if she's alive. In the corner of your eye, the lieutenant steps aside cautiously, his eyes searching for a possible evacuation route. Soona says, the window is going to come down. No, the roof! She looks up, a screech fills the air, a scream of wood and nails. The pillars and of the church twist and creak above and around you. Are we all going to die? Come down to us! Love! Egghead yells, of course. Who else would it be? Pain Threshold says, below it, all the bass grows, like the jaws of a giant compressor gnawing on metal and wood. It does not sound benevolent at all. Visual Calculus says, it's shaking the building's foundation. The floor twists. Composure says, a great pulse arises in your flesh. That's it. I'm muting it. She reaches for the keyboard. Yeah, we should stop. Soona, mute it. It doesn't stop. The woman is furiously pressing down on her keyboard, but the sound doesn't stop. Asel, have you... Yes, I've turned it off, she yells, holding the contact mic in her hand. Andre, pull the compressor. This place is going to come down. Andre frantically smashes buttons. I can't shut it up. The signal's passed. It's not in here. It's... Logic says, in the mixing desk now. Building into a... Mixing desk? Building into a positive feedback loop. Perception hearing says, this is it. A great roar. The vault of the roof twists above you. Glass shatters somewhere near the door. It's coming down. Egghead! It's in the desk! And then stops. Totally and utterly, as if there never was a sound. Only your ears still ring from the shock. Everybody is staring at Egghead, holding a tangling cable in his hand. A black 3-pin connector. Egg? Asel says. I pulled the plug, he says calmly. It was getting too hardcore. You did good, Egg. Andre breathes a sigh of relief and inspects the window. Most of the place seems to be intact. Programmer lady, tell me you were recording that. 4 years, the woman whispers. 22 people, millions of reals. All that time, this is what we were up against? Just erased it. Her lip trembles. Soulless Law isn't going to believe this. Yeah, but did you record it, though? It was dope. I think we can use it, Andre says. Yes, Andre. She composes herself, wipes the dust off her sweater, and rests her hand on the keyboard. I recorded it. Damn, I need to send some letters now. Thank you all for doing this. Eggman, you too. And you, officer. She turns to you. I don't know what we've discovered, but I know what it sounds like now. That's a start. What was that? I've never heard anything like that. It was mathematical information from the anomaly, presented as a waveform. That's what it was technically, theoretically. She shakes her head. I have no idea. I've never even heard of anything like this. Perception hearing says, her voice seems muffled in the silent church. It's your ears adjusting after the exposure. Kim, did you hear that? It was very hard not to. I think you're right. He turns to the woman. There is something going on here, and you need to be very careful with it. I promise, officer, we will not play it again. You're going to write Sula's Law? Yes, our lead designer, and maybe some of the producers, too, and some of the writers, if they're sober enough to open a transmission. They need to hear. Empathy says that it wasn't her fault, or theirs. So these are the people that were writing the RPG. And this is what stopped them? The silence, somehow? I mean, they need to hear about this. Don't worry, I won't send the recording, although I doubt they have the speakers to produce the frequency anyway. Well, still don't send it. The anomaly. That's what stopped them? 4 years, 22 people, millions of reals. This is what we were up against. What happens now? Are you going to stay here? She cuts you off, her deft fingers already on the keyboard. I leveled up. I'm going to stay here with these lunatics, send letters, maybe meet Sula's Law, also devise further measurements. Andre says, I want you to know that's totally chill with us. I don't care, she blurts, then reconsiders, but thank you anyway. Volition says, that's the best she can manage for Andre. It's quite a lot in truth, for her at least. Now, her hands move on the keyboard. I have a theory to come up with, some kind of preliminary explanation to all this, or the letter will sound like I've lost my mind. Yes, Kim says, and we have to get back to stabling Martinez. He breathes out, trying to shake off tension. Instead of demolishing it with loud bass noise of unknown origins. Physical instrument says, some tiny, hard thing lets go in your stomach. You're still alive. Inland Empire says, you have an explanation for all this. Somewhere deep in you, you just don't have the pieces yet. Encyclopedia says, you don't know enough about the world, but that Joyce, if you knew all she knows, could put it together. Very low. Minus 10 for Pale Unknown. I want to learn about Pale. Plus 1 for Heard of Doomed Commercial Area and Investigated Doomed Commercial Area. Form a theory on a 2mm hole in the world. It's logic. How do we learn about the Pale? I wish you could ask Encyclopedia about it. Encyclopedia is passive. I don't think I should. I want to try this, but I don't think I should yet. We have to get 2 sixes, most probably. Are they really going to let us have this? Alright, so what do we got? We have 2 skill points. What, are we a level number? It was just telling us about composure. Anyway. Oh, the map. Andre. I could try Andre again. On the dice maker? I guess, yeah, because it's... Well, that shivers, though. Andre is... Composure. Alright, this is literally all we have. We're gonna offer figurines. That's a dangerous thing. We should do it. Let's check with these people first.
Yeah! Medium car!
Well, that was a crazy sound we heard before. Yeah! It was awesome and scary. Very hard car. His voice booms through the chamber, then gets silent. Too hard car, in fact. He brushes his hand through the air. I couldn't control it. At all. What happened? It sucks up all the air in the mix until it's the only thing left. Starts compressing itself and everything around it. Completely fills up the headspace. Extreme! Physical instrument says, inside your chest, the heart beats still with this after effects of the sound. Imagine if you could harness that power, making it pulse. What if this is the answer to Van Eyck's jam? We could use the sound for the bass. Isn't it a bad thing? Ooh, his puzzled face turns into a wicked grin. But how? Logic says, what about the compressor? The one with the spiky hair was setting up to achieve some sort of parallel processing. The radio onslaught can be tamed. Connect the dots. Okay, plus one for Solve Arno Van Eyck and plus one for Arno's compression algorithm. I think if we talk to the others, maybe we can up that? Andre?
Oh, hey, man. It's good to see you.
He dances over to you in an inexplicably soft-core manner. It's embarrassing. Plus one for Dance Fever incoming. Plus one found the melody. Let's try it. Fail.
But just imagine the moves you could pull to this futuristic beat.
Same thing as last time, so I'm not reading it. I wonder if Kim has anything to say.
Yes?
I guess not. It's gonna be Ring Revachol together.
Welcome back.
Mind if I question you some more? No. Okay, annoyed.
Yo, man! What's on your mind?
He drops a bolt into his toolbox. Dead body, spirit entered. What is there to talk of? You say that as a carpenter yourself? He shakes his head. I don't say much anything as a carpenter anymore. They tried to make me into a reckoner and a leveler. Maybe a bit manic, you know? I regret the time I dedicated to that profession and that worker collective. I say things more as a member of the hardcore Psydance community these days. You're not going to ask me how I knew? Why? You're a cop. I carry carpentry tools. Alright. Let's see if that brought him out. I want to see if I can talk to the crab man again. Is he up there? I don't see anything. I don't see him. I can hear the silence. Alright, stand by, guys. Actually, you know what? I'm going to call in an episode here, and next episode we'll offer a figurine to the Dolores Day stained glass thing. And we'll see how that goes. This is the premiere. Alright, thanks for watching. See you next time, guys, and always seek adventure.